every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Grace and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning to each and every one of you. This is Pastor Daryl Fair, and I am taking this opportunity to welcome you to Fresh Start. It is our morning devotional here at 7 a.m. Eastern Standard Time every single morning. I'll get to that in just a moment, but every single morning we are gathering together to focus our thoughts, to fellowship for just a moment, but to build our faith as we travel through the Word of God. And I am grateful and thankful that you are here and that you have logged on this morning. The Bible says in Lamentations chapter number 3 and verse number 23 that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is His faithfulness to you and I. And so Fresh Start again is our way of beginning a brand new day full of His grace and full of His mercy, and stepping into this brand new day, understanding that God is walking right along with us. For those of you who logged on yesterday or tried to log on yesterday, you didn't see the morning devotional. It is because we were so tired from last night's ministry or the previous night's ministry that we just couldn't get on and get situated enough to do that. So for those of you who were looking for us, who logged on, who went to the place that you would normally meet us, right where you are right now, we are so sorry that we weren't able to get to you. As a matter of fact, as you can probably hear in my voice, it's still suffering a little bit in ministry, but we have had a powerful time in the presence of God while we were here in Jamaica. Today's our last day here. We're on our way back home by the grace of God, and through your prayers, we will make it back safely, and we look forward to seeing you on tomorrow as well as in our impact session. I want to go back to Psalm 27. And we're just adding verses as we go. In Psalm 27, verses 4 through 5, David says, "One thing have I desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in His temple." Then he says, "For in the time of trouble, He shall hide me in His pavilion. And in the secret place, in the secret rather, of His tabernacle shall He hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock." And I'm going to tell you right now that we're going to spend some time in this particular passage of scripture, in this pericope, verse number 5, probably today and tomorrow, because there's so much here. Well, so that we are judicious with our time this morning, I do want to highlight something that he says in this passage of scripture. He says, "In the time of trouble, He shall hide me. In the secret of His tabernacle shall He hide me." In that passage of scripture, he indicates that there will be, and there has been in his own life, times of trouble. If you are human, doesn't matter if you're saved or if you're unsaved, you will have times of trouble. And what David writes about is, he writes about the fact that he has run through an experience with God where he literally ran for his life. I think it's in 1 Samuel. He runs and he finds himself talking to the priest Ahimelech. And while he is there, he is literally running for his life, but he ends up hiding out, as it were, there in that worship space. And God preserved his life. God allowed the priest to give him the sword of Goliath, which David used to chop off the head of Goliath in that story. But he is hiding in a sacred place. He says, in the time of trouble, he shall hide me. Now remember, for this to make sense, we have to remember that David is writing about an experience he's already had with God. And he's using this experience as a point now of worship, as a point of information for those of us who will read and worship within this particular psalm. And he says there will be times of trouble, but in those times of trouble, the Bible says, David writes and says, he shall hide me in the secret of his pavilion. The word pavilion there literally means thicket or a lair, which means there's a place of protection that David has found. And the interesting thing for us this morning is that David says that his secret place, his safety place, happens to be in a sacred place. Let me say that again. That secret place that David uses is not only a secret place, it is a sacred place, and it is a place of safety. He says, I have found my strength, I found my help, I found my protection in this sacred space. Let me give you our fresh focus for this morning. As we close out this morning, I'm way over my time, but let me admonish all of us with these words. Worship is not just a sacred place. It is a safety place. David writes and he tells us that in times of trouble, we can find a hiding place and a safety place in the presence and in the sacred place called worship. And so as we step into this brand new day, I want to remind each and every one of us that as we step into this brand new day, if you're in a season of trouble, if you're in a season of challenge, just know that there is a safety place, there is a pavilion, there is a tabernacle that you and I can find ourselves in and find safety. So I admonish you, I encourage you, find that place, worship in that place, and what you'll find, as we'll talk about tomorrow, the Lord say the same, that there is something that happens that brings safety to you and I when we worship. Listen, that's all the time that I have this morning. I encourage you to worship this morning. Don't focus on your problem. Focus on the problem solver, and that is our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Whatever you lived through on yesterday, just know you've outlived your yesterday. God has brought you into a brand new day. Indeed, God has given you a fresh start. Take this fresh start and know that even in times of trouble, there is a hiding place in your sacred place. Go there. Seek God. Let him be your strength. God willing, I will see you in the morning. God bless. The gospel.